we have a thing we do when we both realize that we are having the same thoughts at the same time, then we'll say it like, lorb, 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 which is like our brainwaves matching up frequencies.
Lorb, 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 lorb.
It happens a lot.
Yeah.
The main part was we wanted people to play with us.
Yeah.
We wanted people to play.
We knew we wanted them to come in costume. It just would have to be really fun and kind of interactive and a party more than a wedding.
Part of the meaning of a timeless love was being to people who don't necessarily believe in reincarnation, but also believe we've known each other in previous lives. That's a complicated thing to experience.
Pretty early on, we sort of decided, I think, that there was going to be time travel involved.
You went blank for a second, and then you looked at me and were like, can a wedding be like that? And I was like, yeah, I think so. And then you were on. Like, then you're... Like your brain.
My creative juices started flowing.
And me.
Come on in, anyone who wants to.
And it was in the sanctuary waiting for us. And we finally came out and in our street clothes. And very apologetically told everyone that there was a mix-up with our costumes and that the tailors had gotten something wrong and that they were going to bring them as soon as they could. But in the meantime, we really needed to get everyone over to the reception hall so that we could have a little bite to eat and make the best of a bad situation.
And we knew that, like, we needed to bring everyone in at the end and be the last ones there because we needed to be in that doorway.
Right.
For the, like, the minion, the villain, to come and take us away.
I don't know what's real, kidnapped. I don't know what's real.
They were kidnapped.
They were kidnapped.
To radiate boundless amounts of joy, which interferes directly with my plans. Without the joy this union would bring, you people will fall at my feet in despair. The world will be powerless against me.
On the time stream, we're gonna need to work together. I need to contact my future self, see if I can contact them telepathically. Okay, are they there? Or maybe through the radio waves? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Wait.
Okay, well, I might be coming through. Unable to connect telepathically and are accessing your time stream directly through the radio waves.
Great.
The Pan-Galactic Chrono Conveyance 5000 replacement parts
right.
are available for your retrieval. The entity who calls himself Doom continues to track the telepathic mind stream. So you must use archaic methods for finding the location of these parts. Agents, you do not have much time or Heidi and Ben will be lost forever. Please employ the support of the additional humans in your proximity.
That's
and
you guys.
Do so as quickly as possible. Sorry, it's cutting out.
I can't hear you anymore.
Seriously.
Cutting out. Oh no. Okay, you guys, there has to be something in here. You need to start looking around. Look for instructions or like folders or like look under chairs, under tables. Look for something. There has to be a clue. We found one. Wait. Okay, look for these. Where did you find this?
In the bottom of the space.
Under the table! Under the table! Look for the instructions for your table!
All of these were leading towards boxes that had been locked with different kinds of locks. And inside of those were parts that we needed for the time machine to work. Got the instructions of how to unlock their box and get the part that they needed for the time machine.
I got some numbers on
you.
You got numbers?
What do you got in there?
What do you got there?
You got a rubber chicken? You got a chicken.
Wow.
The way all of them started was with some info to get people going in one of these inner office memos. This was talking about ways that you can get information between time eras, right? So it was an appendix from the Pan-Galactic Chrono Conveyance 5000 instruction manual. That's what the time machine is. The backstory was that this woman, her Stephanie Lawrence, she is actually an author of romance novels. And our story was that she had stolen Benjamin away from me. And I was really upset about that. And all of the love letters I had sent professing my love to Benjamin had been sent back to me. And I was sure it was because of Stephanie Lawrence. They had a Mad Lib love letter that they had to fill in. My dearest Heidi, long have I eaten in vain to find my way back to you. With each passing hat, new obstacles are placed in my dog. The persistent machinations of my family and an abominable Ms. Lawrence continue to run my hopes and dreams and to keep me trapped here in New York. How I long for your sweet car, your bitchin' glances, your delicious steak and navel pie. Make your way to me. All speed, my darling pasta. Eternally yours, Benjamin. What? And they had to mail that through the time machine to me. And they had to get the postage right. So, of course, to get the postage right, they needed to have another appendix from the instruction manual that showed the different rates for different eras.
Anyone know a Stephanie Lawrence?
And once this got sent, so once they had the postage right, they had a bunch of postage available to them. They put the Mad Lib letter in, and then on the time machine, there was a mail slot. So they had to slip it right through the mail slot and it came through to the other side. And once we saw that this was correct, I came out in my Regency costume.
Well, that's Stephanie Lawrence. I blame her. She's done it. I'll take it, my man.
Oh, dear.
I delivered them the photo, and the photo references a title of one of her books.
We found her. What? Stephanie Lawrence found her? She's the author of those books over there.
Oh!
And they found in that book this mask folded up.
Okay, this is to read something. This is us. What do we read?
They were able to connect it to parts of the letters. And if they matched the flower just right, it revealed to them a title and a number, and those titles matched books, and the page numbers had another clue on them. So each of the letters had a different way of putting the mask on.
Yeah. She fell 209. Smart.
And then she fell 209.
Maybe that's like part of the combination to one of those books.
Are these books related?
And so by the time they got to those books and found those page numbers, they got the instructions of how to unlock their box and get the part that they needed for the time machine.
I really wanted to create like a logic puzzle, like just a pure logic puzzle. And so what we did is we gave them all these posters minus their pictures. And then for each of the people in the pictures, we wanted to, them to be able to match the poster to the picture based on the crimes that they had committed and the description of them as listed on the poster. And so we gave them a bunch of pictures and we gave them a bunch of posters and we let them sort out which ones went with which.
We've got 8 photographs here. And the only one I recognize is John Wayne.
It's not Roy Rogers.
Maybe we just stick one of them on there.
Okay.
If we match them all correctly, maybe
we can... Underground Rabbit Racer, here is the one we are looking for. Kit Shiskins, Carolina Coney. Now wanted for running illegal underground rabbit races all up and down the Mississippi River. Shiskins is mean, ornery, and can hear the law coming from a mile away. If you have information about his whereabouts, please deliver it with all haste to the nearest office of the U.S. Marshal.
All armed and dangerous.
Yep, yep.
Implicated. Yep. Information about their approach with extreme caution.
Yeah, we got all five.
Okay, well, let's put them in the order. I don't know if it matters, but number one, this lady. Number two.
And that was pretty much the first round of the puzzle, was them just having to reconstruct these posters. Once they did that, it was part of the clues was to put one of them onto the time machine, a specific one, this one, Smiling Alex Stanton. I mostly picked that one because I thought the picture was the funniest. And so as soon as they put that poster onto the time machine and the special plank, which was made to represent a saloon wall, that it was time for me to come out in my Western outfit.
Come on! Here's a man who knows how to play poker!
No, I have not received a message.
Not?
And we didn't guess right.
Boy, I'm all in.
I'm betting the cards too.
God damn, I'm about to be a rich man. Read 'em and weep, poor Jack smiling.
I don't think so.
Son of a.
I'll be born swaggled. Of course, won as the plan, and I sort of threw my hat down and threw a little bit of a fit and walked out, and I left my chips that I had lost sitting on the table. You see that some of the chips that I left had a special clues written onto them, and that was what the tables needed in order to progress to the next level of the puzzle. For the ancient one, I was really stuck. I had some ideas about what I wanted, but I didn't really know. I knew we wanted an ancient map. And for it to have a feel of like exploration and discovery.
You said, I just want to have an Indiana Jones feel. And I said, when I think Indiana Jones, I think an object goes on the thing while he takes the other object off and it's supposed to have to be the same weight or something like that. And all I had to do was describe that and then your brain lit up.
We basically ended up making this map, which was loosely based on the room where the wedding reception was taking place.
You look like someone who could figure it out.
There are plenty clues of some kind, I'm sure.
And we had these encoded messages along the sides of the map. And when they decoded those messages, then the idea was that they would find objects that were hidden in plain sight in the room where the reception was happening. These hidden messages are written in a made-up language that I found on the internet, and then the way they would decipher them was to look at the label on the time machine, which is written both in English and in that same alien script. And so I had to make sure that the label contained one of each, at least one of each of the letters of the alphabet.
Korjak.
Korjak.
The company that made this?
That A is that symbol. These are the same thing written in two different alphabets.
Okay.
So whatever you see in this writing,
Yeah, that's how I figure out.
That's how you figure
this
out.
This is Korjak.
Yes.
Okay.
Someone, we need paper. Does anyone have a paper?
It's not dangerous.
You need paper and something to write with.
In the candlestick, they found a little tube that had a scroll rolled up in it.
They have the messages.
They had these messages in them. In each of these messages, they're written as if they were written by someone like Indiana Jones, who is looking for a lost treasure and leaving clues behind. Ignore the Milton quote. It's a dead end. Find the translation in the codex for this. Ive oisve ave Ephyrus ze, which is the voice of Zephyrus in Pig Latin. And then it says, I'm counting on you. And so here is the Fawn of Diana. And the idea was that they would go find the fawn, and they had already discovered this. And so they would realize that they needed to look at the feet, and they would pull it apart, and there was a false leg under the fawn. And so they would replace it with this. They would put this back. When they put all of that together, what they had found was the Rod of Destiny and also the Scroll of Destiny.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Or is that the very...
Oh, yeah, there it is.
You got the key?
I do.
So what they had to do then was put the rod into the rod holder with the scroll on it. And as they pulled the scroll out, the black light shone onto the invisible ink and told them their next instructions, which was to read a Latin phrase aloud to the entire room.
That's brilliant! So,
I don't think it's... You have to actually put it onto the time machine, right? So see how there's this thing here?
Gotcha.
And in the world...
Yeah, the first word, the proclaim love and...
Proclaim love and...
Go, do it in Latin, that's probably better.
Okay.
Amore...
Amore e mele et fele es feculissimus.
Did it work?
They don't make this easy.
It worked!
Once they did that, then they summoned me in my Roman outfit, and I proceeded to give them the keys that would unlock the box for the next piece of the time machine.
Ladies and gentlemen, we only have one more box to open.
The clock is backwards.
We wanted for the future folks to kind of look back in time and have a survey of all of the other times that we were dealing with. So, what we did was we gave them this cryptic kind of pages, a couple pages from the time machine manual, and one of them is a tangram that they have to solve, and then the other one is sort of a foundation for them to solve it on. Little by little, we were hoping that they would basically figure out how to create this shape using these pieces on this page. And once they did, what you can see is that, like, for example, what's revealed here is... It has some sort of technobabble gibberish, but when you put this here, then it says, in Rome, find a map, right? So that's ancient, the ancient map from ancient Rome. They had to look and try to find one of the pieces of the map, and that was going to be a clue for them. What happened was that they would find clues from each of the other eras, and the giveaway was that they would have this Stobaeus Industries stamp on them.
When you find a clue from your table that has the Stobaeus Industries stamp on it, hold it under the black light.
Okay. The clue from my table.
Okay, so here's the map from ancient Rome.
I think we're done with the map. Nope!
Oh!
See? Oh! StobaeusIndustries.com/
I got it. I'm going.
Everyone was like, oh, it's not on the back, and I was like, yes, it is.
You know, you got this. Yeah, you know.
We compiled the email with all the clues, and then now I have an email thread with Courgette.
Meanwhile, we were in the back room with our email client loaded up on our computer. He said, what's the nature of your problem? And we kind of answered them as if we were technicians for the time machine company.
We'll send a technician to your location as soon as possible. Thanks.
Oh, I actually know what this means. What? You guys need to clear the area. Technician's going to come.
Oh,
a
technician.
Yeah. The technician, of course, was played by the lovely Heidi Stauber, who appeared in this jacket. And zoom in on that QR code and then open it, and there was the next clue.
Duet. D-U-E-T.
Robot. Next clue was in fact the combination to a lock, which was a letter lock. So it was a combination lock that used letters instead of numbers.
Not only did they have a part to the machine in their lock box, But they also had the schematic of exactly where those parts had to go to make the time machine work.
Okay. So the schematic will tell us where each of these items go on the machine.
Okay. All right, okay.
So that it would be reactivated.
Mary and River are going to help us figure out where on the time machine each of these things go. So there you go.
Mary has that one.
Okay, so where does that go? Okay, okay. Where does the top go? Yeah. Who has the camera?
Okay.
Stick it in there.
Oh, who's got the rubber chicken?
I do, right here.
Okay, where is the rubber chicken?
River, River, will you put the rubber chicken in?
Okay, I think it's together. Woo! It's okay. The time machine is taking off. All the lights are on. Okay, you guys, Ben and Heidi are, they're being sent for right now. They're coming into our time. So everybody, get back to the sanctuary.
It was amazing.
Yeah, I agree. It was exactly what we wanted it to be. It was so fun.
It had everything.
Yeah, and it was...
It was perfect.
It was perfect.
And it was not only the games and puzzles, which were the main meat of what we really worked on, was like making all those things happen and then the decor, but also the wedding itself. And, you know, we went from this riotous, crazy mayhem and everybody in costumes and just berserk, and then got them into the sanctuary again, came out in our real wedding clothes, and 5 minutes into it, everybody's crying and like it's just the most beautiful thing you've ever seen. And like, what an amazing journey we got to take ourselves and everybody else on.
Yeah, it was exactly what we hoped it to be. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, if you're going to throw an escape room wedding,
we nailed
it. The way to do it.
We did it.
It was great.